Warning. Curse of Strahd. Spoilers ahead. We rejoin Xaeli the Ranger, Nala the Druid, Barakas the Rogue, Torrin the Paladin, Xandala, Boblia, and Ireena just as the party awakens from a reasonable night's rest in the Sarapool encampment. Those who partook in the drinks and partied the night prior experienced no ill effects from the wine, other than slight dehydration or possibly a hangover. Barakas wants to sleep for 5 more hours. Xaeli whacks Barakas with her Staff of the Serpent. No, Barakas does not want to go to school. Xaeli whacks him again. Barakas is never going to have to read.
And he never did.
Before we continue, please make sure you've subscribed to my channel. It helps me out a lot. Barakas grudgingly rises and the party makes ready to leave. The current goal is to take Ireena to one of two walled villages in Barovia, the village of Valaki to the north, or the village of Kresk to the northwest.
Have you decided where you'd like to be taken, Ireena? Kresk is far from the walls of Ravenloft. I'd prefer a good distance between myself and the vampire. Which way is Kresk? It's to the northwest. If we follow this path, it should take us to Sare Falls. I'm sure we'll be able to get to plenty of places from there. Or we could backtrack and take the high road over the bridge, though it takes us by the castle.
Maybe let's not go by the castle.
West it is.
Are we going to Zone of Truth, Ireena, here or down the road?
Probably not smart to do it in a camp full of unknown people.
Yeah.
They were basically cheerleaders for Strahd last night.
I forgot about that.
Barakas, we'll go west.
Barakas, you're going the wrong way.
Duh. Barakas thought this way was west.
West? I thought you said east.
Xaeli thanks the gracious Vistani hosts before the party leaves the Sarapool encampment.
Come back any time!
The party walks along the river Sare until they come to a great waterfall that spills into a pool, billowing forth clouds of cold mist. A great stone bridge spans a huge expanse, nearly 1,000 feet above the party's heads.
End of the road. How exactly are we going to get up on that bridge?
Xandala, do you mind taking us to the bridge, my darling?
Everyone just needs to get ready. Bear in mind I won't be able to cast many powerful spells for the rest of the day. I'll just windwalk us. We just need to get up to that bridge, is that it? It'd be a good start. Where are we going after the bridge? We need to head north and then far to the west. Kresk is on the borders of Barovia.
Nala spends a minute casting windwalk and the party starts turning into misty clouds. Suddenly the transformations stop and a horrid cackling is heard. Nala staggers, suddenly struck with a level of exhaustion.
Rude?
Nala suddenly hears a voice in her head, though it's nothing like the horrid cackling. The voice is measured, almost as if waiting to speak for some time.
Well met, traveler. It has been long since any dared to soar above my lands. Please, come dine with me in Castle Ravenloft. Your path there is safe.
Oh dear. Okay, guys, someone in Castle Ravenloft has noticed me and has invited me to dinner. Yes. Apparently people don't try to fly above his land very often, and he would enjoy some company. Nala, should we try the fly spell, or should we just walk?
It seems like whatever spells we're going to do to try to bypass things might have the same result.
And then he'll know you're here. I assume at this point, since I'm the only one who heard him, that I'm the only one visible. In that sense. Where's the castle from here? To the northeast. So we're going northwest and he's to the northeast. It's why I prefer Kresk. It's further away from Valaki and about as far away from Strahd as we can get.
Yeah, particularly if Strahd wants Ireena. We should get her to Kresk first.
That's true. We've been invited, but he didn't say when, and that's his own fault. I should be able to wild shape and fly us up, even if it's one at a time. I'd rather not spend both uses on an air elemental if I can help it.
After several hours, Pteranodon Nala manages to finagle the entire party up the cliff. Torrin and Barakas are naturally the most difficult part of the ascent, but the party finally stands on the vast stone expanse over Sare Falls. Why did I allow her to do this after I didn't let her do it in Tomb of Annihilation? Honestly, I forgot. But if I forget past rulings and it goes in the favor of the party, good for them! The party heads north and west, following a winding dirt road for several miles.
Barakas is hungry.
Why don't you eat some of the food I made you?
That food doesn't have any blood in it.
That's a fair point.
Barakas, why don't you learn to hunt?
Barakas does, but then the city guards come after Barakas goes hunting.
There's no city guards here.
There's no prey either.
Rabbits?
Wait, that's prey? Barakas thought they were pets.
Large gates loom in the distance, and a weirdly familiar figure suddenly appears on the road ahead.
This f***er.
He looks like a boy.
Vasili is standing near the aforementioned massive gates that lead further into the gloom. He is again garbed strangely, as if he got dressed in the dark and checked no mirrors upon his departure. What is it with nobles and having no fashion sense? Did Vasili go,
"Oh, this is something commoners wear,"
or something like that?
"Hey, I know you. Fancy we keep running into each other. I'm beginning to get the hang of meeting you, huh?"
I'm gonna put a spell on you.
I mean, we heard him coming. Wait, did you walk here? Or did you have...
Are you able to turn into a bat?
Turn into a bat? What do you mean? No one can turn into bats. That's silly.
I can turn into bats. What are you talking about?
Okay, prove it.
But I don't want to waste a spell slot. Haven't you heard of magic?
Oh, I see. Excuses. You can't turn into a bat. I knew you were fibbing.
You haven't offered me anything worth turning into a bat for you.
Vasili pulls out a silver.
One silver?
Oh, come on. You haven't even proven you can do it.
Well, if you don't trust my word after this long of knowing each other, Vasili, then I have nothing to offer you.
Hold on. I haven't known you that long.
We exchanged gifts.
She fished with you.
And I fished with you in the middle of nature.
All right. Fine. I'll give you a gold.
I suppose it's almost nighttime anyway. Fine. It's not that I mind doing it. It's that Vasili wanted me to transform because he said so. Pay me for it.
Nala transforms into a small bat.
Oh, it's the vampire!
Nala flutters around and transforms back.
I would have landed on him, but he's being all weird and...
Yeah, not a great idea to land on him, because he might swat you away like a loser.
Should have been a giant bat to extra freak him out. Hope sometime I see one of those. Do giant bats exist?
It's the size of a pelican, but it's a bat.
That's terrifying. Wait, really?
Nala, can you get your gold and we can turn this guy loose?
Fine. Happy? See? I told you I could.
That was terrifying and entertaining in a weird way.
Wait, why does Nala always get your money? The rest of us can't turn into bats.
I could have polymorphed you. That would have been fun. Maybe I should have polymorphed him.
He would have had a meltdown.
You turn us all into bats and he's just a puddle of tears?
Vasili, would you like to be a bat?
No.
Are you sure?
Maybe we just bully Vasili into a psychiatric state of...
Vasili stabs his spear into the ground.
You know what? I feel like a hunt. Does anyone want to go on a hunt with me?
Sure, I'm great at hunting.
But I guess is in as long as the animals don't run too fast. Care to put on a wager?
Oh yeah.
No, but I guess is poor. We're gonna go hunt. What do you want to hunt, actually?
What is there in this area?
There's rabbits, deer, bats, ravens.
Let's do deer.
Excellent. This will undoubtedly be more complicated than a simple fishing excursion. Are you ready?
Yeet.
Xaeli and Vasili bound off into the wilderness, spread out just enough so that they might not pursue the same quarry. Xaeli immediately picks up a deer's trail and sprints after it. She can hear Vasili crashing through the underbrush some distance away, but that's of little concern. Suddenly, up ahead, Xaeli spies a deer. Without thinking, she knocks an arrow and fires. The deer immediately drops, though yelling can be heard from Vasili's direction. Vasili, a little too hyped about the chase, accidentally threw his spear straight into the ground before yelling in frustration.
Another!
Are there enough nearby deer for another round? It's probably safer if you don't question it.
The hunt begins again. Xaeli runs off into the underbrush, leaving Vasili looking confused and flustered as he tries to regain his composure. In the time it takes Vasili to spot and pursue another deer, Xaeli has engaged her second deer. Xaeli fires an arrow but misses, her shot vanishing into the thick forest trees. Vasili clumsily blunders after his deer, barely able to prevent it from escaping. Xaeli misses another shot as Vasili starts to close in on his deer.
Aha! Soon we shall be one kill each.
Not likely.
Xaeli cranks a final arrow at her second deer, dropping it just as Vasili manages to put a spear in his first deer.
Alas, it seems I am outmatched, but it was fun.
Vasili tosses Xaeli a small pouch filled with 100 gold coins.
Oh, yee! Okay, bye, bitch.
What do you mean, bye? Can I have these deer at least?
I'm gonna keep the deer I hunted, but you can keep the deer you hunted.
Oh, come on. Can't I have just one of your deer?
We obviously have more people than you. What are you gonna do with two full-grown deer before they spoil?
Jerky, possibly.
I like to use the hides to make hunting clothes.
Well, you look stupid and you're not a very good hunter.
That's not very nice.
It's true. Truth hurts.
Don't mess with her. She eats Barakas.
You may as well let him have it.
Fine, you can have the f***ing hide, but we get the meat. It's just that if you can't hunt, I don't know what you're doing here.
She eats you, devil man? How does that work?
Xaeli pulls out her water skin of Barakas's ashes, casually dips a finger in the water skin.
No, Xaeli, don't.
And licks some of the ashes.
That's how.
Barakas is inside that bag from when Barakas died.
Vasili gags.
Why would you put ashes in your mouth? That's disgusting. How do you think Barakas field. Those are Barakas's ashes. Hold on, but you're here. Those can't be your ashes. You're standing in front of me.
Oh, sweetie, you haven't experienced the world.
I feel like this guy conveniently forgets the world is filled with magic.
He's like a baby who woke up with a wardrobe of clothes, and he's ready to challenge us to things he knows nothing about.
Vasili, to his credit, starts field dressing his own deer without rising to any of the insults.
At least you can do something basic.
I'll have you know there are skilled butchers in this land. I happen to be one of them.
Okay, why don't you just go make your outfits?
Weird that a nobleman would be trained in a profession usually designated to commoners.
My several times great-grandfather was once a butcher. Quite a butcher.
He killed people, didn't he?
Was there a war? Was there unrest?
What do you mean, a war?
Why was there fighting?
Oh, people don't like taxes or when others encroach on their business, and he was a businessman of absolute sense. When the crown encroached on him, he stabbed the tax collectors. Brought in quite a few guards, though.
A Vlad the Impaler businessman.
Huh?
And that got you up to nobility, huh?
If you kill the right people, certainly.
Fair enough.
Thank you all for the fun. I'll be seeing you.
Hone up on your skills.
I will. Next time, I will win.
Unlikely.
Vasili laboriously drags his deer through the open gate and vanishes into the mist.
Barakas would like to have some deer. Barakas is hungry.
We'll set up camp and have a feast. Maybe some smothered steak in the morning.
The evening watch is quiet, save for the occasional snapping of twigs on the edge of the camp.
Torrin?
Hmm?
Is there something out there?
Yes, but it's keeping its distance. We'll let it go so long as it behaves.
Is this a thing to which one becomes accustomed?
Late nights staring off into the darkness? No. I'll take the four walls of an inn over the unknown of the wilderness. At least there's maybe two directions you can get ambushed from.
Do you make a habit of getting ambushed?
Torrin rattles his armor. Blade is loud. It's pretty easy to figure out where I am.
It would explain why you and your friends are no strangers to combat.
Often not by choice.
You bear a wide assortment of arms and armor, yet do not choose battle. That seems contradictory.
Most creatures aren't inherently evil.
Predisposition to evil doesn't necessarily mean fighting.
If two sides perceive the other as evil, it's only a matter of time. That and undead.
Are undead not controlled by some other power? Does that make them especially evil?
I'm not gonna split hairs with you, Ireena. I took an oath to become a paladin serving Bahamut, devoting myself to a god whose domains are of life and war. While war usually creates death, life contradicts death. I take it upon myself to snuff out undead when I have the power to do so.
I see.
Why don't we talk about you? How did you end up courted by a vampire in the dead of night?
It's hard to remember. All I can recall is blazing eyes that fail to hide a tremendous hunger.
Yeah, but why you?
I don't know. I didn't ask for any of this.
No one in their right mind would. Did Kolyan notice anything about you while you were growing up?
What do you mean?
Any spellcasting abilities? Unnatural powers? Anything?
Not that I'm aware of.
How helpful. The whole Tatyana thing that Madam Eva started doesn't make this any easier either.
I have no idea who this Tatyana is. Will no one believe me?
We largely do. It's just bizarre that she would be so certain, especially after doing a creepy tarot reading.
Perhaps she is mistaken.
It's possible. It's also possible your memory could have been altered. There are many possibilities, but we're going to Zone of Truth you to figure out what that truth is.
You had warned me in advance I am to be interrogated.
If you want our continued protection, yes. We won't cut you loose in the Barovian wilds, but it's likely we'll take you right back to the village of Barovia if you refuse to talk to us.
How does the zone work?
I cast a spell and you choose not to resist a slightly unpleasant feeling that you're not allowed to lie. I can tell whether or not you comply. We busted a doppelganger who tried to lie some time ago.
A doppelganger?
It's a really long story.
It seems we have time left in your watch.
I'll give you the crucial details. We saved a group in a similar situation and had a sneaking feeling that someone was false. I did the spell work while Nala and Xaeli interrogated the people until we caught them.
Can't one keep silent to avoid telling the truth?
Absolutely, but that's not an option. Plus, sometimes one feels better after getting the truth off their chest.
Can one feel better after being interrogated? Good night, Torrin.
The morning arrives without further incident, if you can call it morning. Life in Barovia is literally overshadowed by dark clouds at all times, giving it a near constant twilight feeling except for when the dark of night finally swallows the land. As the party proceeds through the nearby gate, leading further into Barovia, the gate squeals ominously in the breeze before it slams itself shut behind them. Despite this happening, the road is silent and devoid of other entities. Many hours of walking later, the party sees a decrepit windmill in the distance.
Oh, there was something about a windmill, right?
Hang on.
A lonely mill on a precipice. The treasure lies within. Let's go!
Is it on a precipice?
How much is the fork worth? Barakas wants to pick it up.
Barakas, you can't pick up roads.
Shows what Torrin knows.
Does the mill look lonely? Are we sure it's the right place?
There's nothing else around it. I would assume yes.
Does it seem like a popular windmill? Or if you saw it at school, would it be like, that's a windmill that needs friends?
Yeah, we have to go in the f***ing windmill.
But as their party sets their eyes on the lonely windmill, another entity has firmly set eyes on them.
Their insolence insufferably grows. Beloved Ireena, are these playthings a bad influence? There was a time you dared not utter my name. They laugh in the face of death. The ashes are a lie, a ruse, but a clever one. We shall see. Cyrus!
My lord!
Have dinner set for 7, plus a hound.
Right away, must please the master, yes.
Rahadin! Strange.
A quick thank you to my patrons. And thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe button, smash that like button, share this video on your Twitter, Facebook, or other social media, and consider becoming one of my patrons on Patreon. I'll see you all next time.